Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about what divided difference interpolation is and Newton polynomials. The divided difference interpolation algorithm is essentially a method to find the coefficients for a curve-fitting polynomial. So, if you've been following along with this numerical methods course, you'll likely understand what this means. Briefly, when interpolating in numerical methods, we are trying to find a function that will fit through all of our data points and describe the behavior of our discrete data in a continuous function, rather than our given discrete data points. If you have not been following this course, I will leave some links to videos in the description down below that should help your understanding. In the divided difference method, we use Newton polynomials as our interpolating functions. A Newton's polynomial are just polynomials used to interpolate discrete data points from a given data set. But you may ask, we have learned about Lagrange polynomials, why can't we just use those? Well, Newton polynomials through divided difference has many advantages, as it is faster, recursive, and through such, better, faster, and much more widely used than the Lagrange polynomials. We will talk about why this is the case later on in the video. Back to talking about the divided difference method, we can intuitively think of this through the following example. Let's imagine that we have a pot of water being heated slowly on a stove, where we are tracking the temperature increase of the water at different points in time. And this gives us the following discrete data points. Graphically, this data set will look something like this. Then we are going to use the divided difference algorithm to find a continuous function using Newton's polynomials that pass through all of the points like this. Then we can find the output for any point within the bounds of our applied data set. The general formula for an nth order Newton's polynomial is written here. Where n is our order of the Newton polynomial, which is simply the number of data points that we have, minus 1. And to solve a Newton's polynomial, all we are going to do is find the coefficients that I've highlighted here. These coefficients can be written in many following ways. However, they all mean the same thing, and they are called our divided differences, hence the name. I'm just going to take a second and write out the general first-order Newton's polynomial here. So, let's begin talking about how we find the Newton polynomial coefficients and what they look like. Well, let's start simple with only two data points and derive this formula to better understand divided difference interpolation. With two data points, remember that we have an n minus 1 order Newton polynomial, and therefore we need a first order Newton polynomial, which looks like this. The divided difference of f0 will simply be y0, as if you think about it, with only one point, our polynomial must pass through every point. Therefore, it can only logically be y0. At x1, we know that our Newton polynomial will have to be y1, as it must pass through all of the points. Therefore, we can rearrange for this coefficient that we wish to solve for, and we can do that like so. And there we go. We just found the divided difference coefficient for a first-order Newton's polynomial. I will link a great video in the description down below for a second order derivation if you're interested. The biggest advantage to Newton's polynomials is that they are recursive, meaning if we wanted to add a data point to our interpolation function, we do not need to redo all of the math again. We can just add in a new term on the end of our Newton polynomial, and this allows us to create what are called divided difference tables that utilize this recurrence relationship that I mentioned earlier. As you can see, our new middle value is just continually taking the divided difference of the two lower orders that construct it. Through this table, we can easily find our necessary coefficients for our Newton's polynomial, as the top row here is all of the divided difference coefficients necessary to find your interpolating polynomial. In the coming videos, I will complete examples walking through several divided difference problems. So, stay tuned for those if you are at all confused about this topic or just want more practice. I hope that this video helped your understanding of what Newton's polynomials are and the divided difference method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.